Something is wrong. Something is very, very wrong. Minecraft was never meant to have circles. What the fuck is this? Hello everybody, Pokepeel here, and welcome back to another Minecraft Mod Spotlight. Okay, so today's mod that we will be taking a look at is the Clockwork Phase Mod. Now this is a pretty new mod, and I will say it looks gorgeous and awesome. And I look forward to actually messing around with this mod in single player and stuff as well as that. So, but yeah, so let's pop into it! So what this mod does is it's meant to mess with time, and time is your friend and probably sometimes your enemy, but the first thing that you are going to want from this mod is a mainspring. Now a mainspring is made really simply by putting some iron around a stick of any kind, and then once you have your little spring, then you are going to have 0 to 2000 tension. Now tension is basically what this mod needs. It's your, I guess, kind of energy source. There is multiple different types of energy source. But if we get ourselves a mainspring, so mainspring, and we get one that's got 0 to 0. Now each thing that this mod has, so we've got different types of metal from different mods as well. So we've got brass ingots here, and we've also got inbar blocks. Now if we stick this in here and we surround it by brass ingots, then you'll see that we now have 22,400 tension. But if we get rid of this brass and we bring in some invar blocks, I think this is actually one of the highest things you can have, then it will make it to 288,000 tension. Now we're going to fill this up with invar blocks because this is one of the best ways to get it to the highest type of tension that we can possibly get it. And then we have 1 million tension. So that is the highest that you can get it. You can get it up to 1 million and that is it. So the next thing you are going to want to create is a clockwork. Now clockwork doesn't have a recipe because it can be made with multiple different things called clockwork components. Now what clockwork components are, they are gears and things, which we will get to in a moment, and there are also different little artifacts and things that you can get with different like aspects. So the aspects that I'm talking of are these things underneath the name of the object, which are quality and speed. Now there is also another one called memory. So there is quality, speed and memory. Now when you are making your clockwork component, you are going to want to take these into consideration because these are what are made into different things such as the pickaxes or the tools and the armor, also with some other things later on I believe. So we're going to put this one in here, and you can see that we're making a clockwork with 0 memory, 25 speed and 50 quality. Items used, 1. So you can see here with a bronze gear we get that on that. Whereas if we put a diamond gear in and we take out of this bronze gear, then it will make it with 60, 40 speed. And if we put in more of these, then these will combine and they will make it higher. Now we can also mix and match these in different ways. So we can take those out, put those in and make it however we want to. So 500 quality, 300 speed, I guess that's okay, we'll take that one out. As I said, you can make this with multiple different things, so I'm now going to go on to the gears. So, actually, I don't want to go on to the gears yet. I want to go on to the brass ingot. So the brass ingot's pretty easy to make. All you need is 3 iron and 1 gold, and you'll get 3 brass ingots. So that's pretty simple. You can then make those into a brass block by putting 9 together, and that is what this is. This is brass block, and it looks pretty sweet. So now the gears. So we have the brass gear, which gives you 20 quality and 55 speed. We then have the bronze gear, which gives you 50 quality and 25 speed. We have the copper one, which gives you 40 quality and 30 speed. We have the diamond one, which is 60 to 40. Emerald is 35 to 60. Iron is 45 to 25. Lead is 70 to 10. And then we've got silver, which is 25 to 50, steel, which is 80 to 20, and then we have the temporal gear, which we will get into temporal things later on, but that gives you 20 quality, 90 speed, and 150 memory. So that is one thing with memory. Also, Fumium has memory because it is a magical component and therefore doesn't have basic things. So that gives you 45 quality, 40 speed, and 120 memory. And then we have the Tin Gear, which is 30 quality, 40 speed. Now, all of these are made pretty simply by putting four ingots together with sticks in the corners. And that is how all of these are made with their corresponding parts. So, pretty simple. Steel, we don't actually have steel in the game, so I can't show you that one. Temporal, we will get to this stuff a little bit later. Fumium, we don't have installed, so we can't show you that recipe. And then, the last thing here is an hourglass, which we will need a little later on. But that is made with seven glass, like so. So, pretty simple, pretty cool, and pretty easy to make. Now, we are gonna move on to the tools. So the tools are really simple to make. All you need is a framework, two brass ingots, two sticks, and that will give you the clockwork pickaxe. Now all of these you'll see tension, quality speed, memory, and time sand. Now time sand we're not going to worry about at the moment. But the clockwork axe is made like so. A framework, two brass ingots, and two sticks. The shovel is made with one framework and two sticks. The sword is made with one framework and five brass ingots and one stick. Now, to make framework, all you need is five brass ingots and four iron. So, not too hard to make and pretty cool. Now, we got the armor, which I will show you what these tools and armor and stuff do in a moment. There's a reason that I have these tension springs at the bottom. So the helmet, pretty simple, again, framework, which actually gives you 80 quality if you want to use it as a component, so do keep that in mind. You can use that as a component to make your little one of these, the clockworks, so that's pretty cool. Right, the chest plate is one framework and seven brass ingots. The head is four brass ingots and one framework. Trousers, six brass ingots, one framework, and the boots are one framework and four, so that's pretty simple, pretty cool. And then we are gonna look at what these tools can do when combined with some different little cool things. So as I said before, these have quality and speed. These can be added together with other components and things, so if we put all diamond together it'll give us higher stuff, and it won't give us any memory. But we have higher quality, but less speed. So we're going to take that out. Right, now we are going to look at our axe. So we got zero tension. So to give this tension, we put it in the crafting grid with a main spring with any number of tension. And it will give it the number of tension that is on the spring. And then we have ourselves some tension in here. So we now have tension, you can see. So 1,000,000 tension. Then we want to combine it with a clockwork to give it a function, because otherwise if we, let's say we go into normal adventure or whatever mode, and we want to chop down one of these trees. I mean, why would you make an axe if you're not going to chop down a tree? So if we want to chop down a tree, this won't do anything. As you can see, we can break other blocks with it like normal, but the block that it's meant to do, it won't do anything because we haven't got any modifiers. So that's basically what the clockwork is. So if we give it, let's give it more quality and stuff, so that one, combine it with the components that we have, it will now have some speed on it and some quality, which will make it more effective and stuff. So this still won't do anything though, because unfortunately we don't have any tension build up. So it won't actually do anything. As I said, the tension is basically your energy supply in this mod. So how are we going to get tension into this axe, you may ask? Well, we need a thing called a winding box. Now what a winding box does is it builds your tension by right clicking on it. To make this, you need five brass ingots and two iron. So pretty, not, I wouldn't say it's too expensive to make. And the stuff, we will get that, and then, well, actually, we don't even need that, we've already got it placed down. So this is the winding box. If we right click here, you'll see the little bar on our axe, slowly going up the more we right click, so it'll eventually go to green and then stop, and we've got ourselves a full tensionized axe. So there you go, you can see we've got a million out of a million. You can now see that that makes really, really short work of this. So achieve getting wood. Awesome! But let's say that you made your axe too low tension or something later on, and you want to build it up. Let's say you started on really low gears and stuff, and you wanted a higher tier of gears, such as something like fumium. So if you wanted those, or you wanted something like emeralds instead of diamonds, even though I don't know where you would apart from speed. So, and you decide that, right, I'm really not happy with this design. You can modify it. For the modification, you will need a disassembler. A disassembler is really easy to make. All you need is 6 bronze in a pattern like so, and you'll get yourselves a disassembler. Now, before I disassemble this, you will see that my energy went down in the tension went down. This is because I used the axe to dig to cut down some of that tree, so it does use some of the tension. And when it gets to zero, then you'll have to recharge it. So to disassemble one of these little things, you are going to want to right-click on the disassembler, and it will give us our component back, or our clockwork back. And it will also give us our spring back. So spring doesn't have any tension anymore, as you would probably expect. And you can't right click the spring on here, so that is okay. So let's say that we wanted something completely different. Let's just say we wanted to get a load of different things. So let's put the fumium gear and the temporal gear together. Let's just do that. Let's stick those together. Actually, no, let's stick together the bronze gears. So we got really low quality and a little bit lower speed than we had before. Let's stick that in there. We need a tension as well, so our mainspring. And then we can have a pickaxe. Now, this basically does the same sort of thing as the axe. It will dig, and of course, we will need tension in this before it does anything. So, righty-clicky! So, when we're breaking blocks, you can see it is very slow. Well, I wouldn't say it's the slowest pickaxe I've ever used, but it's not exactly fast and lightning speed. So to get this to lightning speed, all we just need to do is basically make faster gears, or have faster gears inside of our thing. So let's see, we've got 50 there. What do we have? That should be faster. So emerald gears, that is what we're going to use for this. We're going to use emerald gears because emerald has a higher speed but less quality. So there we go, our clockwork component. And then let's disassemble that, get ourselves our components back. We can then stick in our new gear, or our new clockwork, our new spring, and then stick it with the pickaxe. There we go. And you can see this makes really light work of stuff, so it breaks it so easily. So that is how the speed makes it different. But you're going to need a celestial compass core. So to make a celestial compass core, you will need a clock, a gas tier, a bone, a golden apple, a block of glowstone, some water in a bucket, one stone, one feather, and a flint and steel. Now, once you've got your celestial compass core, you are going to want to place this down anywhere in the world, and I'm going to stick it here because I got a place ready for it. And it will make this nice, lovely pattern. Now, I know it's circular and I hate circle things in Minecraft, but this is really, really nice. I love the design of it. Now, you can place this anywhere, as I said, but do recognize that if there's an obstacle in the way, then it will emit some red particles that will basically say, no, you're not allowed here, and it will block the construction of it. So that is cool. But you can place this anywhere. It will automatically generate itself. You don't have to do anything. And then that is cool. But we can't do anything with this yet, because we need a chronomancer's hourglass, which is the next tier to the hourglass, because the hourglass doesn't actually do anything. So we will need to get ourselves some temporal ingots. And to get that, we need temporal nuggets. So when you're exploring the world and killing mobs, there is a slight chance that they will drop one of these, a precious charm. I believe it's a 1% chance that they will drop this, so a very low chance that you will get it. But if you do, then you can move on to the temporal stuff, because it has memory. Now, as I said before, you can also use the Fumium gears if you have Fumcraft installed to help and get memory as well, as long with the temporal stuff, which we'll get to later, as I said. But you can use Fumium, which is what we're going to use at the moment. I'm going to then stick it with some diamond gears and some emerald gears to make this better. So there you go, we can see that we got 120 memory. But let's say we need more than this. We really need more. So we're going to go with a load of these. So I know that our mining speed is going to be really slow and our quality is not going to be great, but we've got mainly a lot of memory, or supposedly, so 4,120 memory. And then we're going to stick our clockwork with our pickaxe and our tension. And now that when we look at this, we can shift click and there is a chance that we can extract time sand. Now, memory is the thing that basically allows you to get time sand. The less memory you have in your tool, the less likely you are going to have time sand turn up. The chance of extracting time sand from digging with the pickaxe is 1 in 3,106. So you've got a very low chance of being able to actually get anything from this. So we're going to be digging forever. I mean, even if it is a pickaxe. And that was with a lot, and I mean a lot of those precious charms, which have a 1% drop rate. So we are going to get ourselves some levels. This is the next best thing for using or getting time sand. If you leveled up, then if we go back into our pick now, you can see we've got 1 in a 15 chance. So the user's experience help a lot. Now we've got a 1 in 10 chance. We got a 1 in 5 chance of getting this. So let's see if we do this. Come on, you gotta give us some time sand. There you go. So you can see little yellow particles came out there when we broke that rock. And that gave us some time sand. So that gave us 25, which isn't really a lot. They got some more there. And time sand automatically goes into the tool that you are using. So cool. Now if we have enough time sand in here, which I'm not sure that we do, we can press Z, I believe it's actually R, but I've rebinded it, so you can see there's Z, so I'm going to change that back to R, and there's a multi-tool called V as well, but the temporal abilities are binded to R. So now let's get back into the game, and if we press R, then it will turn us into our pickaxe into a temporal clockwork pickaxe. Now if we right click on the ore, which we currently can't because we don't have enough, god damn it. Okay, so I just leveled myself up to level 30, and now we are going to go back into that and right click on our block. And you can see we've got 2 temporal nuggets. We can try and do that again, but I believe it, yeah, it uses 200 per right click on a block. So, and then it will go back to the normal pickaxe. So time sand is quite an essential thing to get ourselves some nuggets. The same sort of thing applies to the shovel, apart from you want to be mining dirt, sand and stuff like that. With the sword, you want to be killing mobs, and basically with the different tools, you want to be going to the corresponding things. I'm dying because I'm underwater, owie! Now currently, I believe that all of the temporal thing does is basically speeds up your stuff. So there you go, you can see clockwork, or our clockwork quality and speed is times by 3. And that is what the temporal does on this at the moment. I believe there will be stuff later on because there is like things called temporal sand and stuff, but currently I don't believe that they are implemented at the moment. So if we now look in my pickaxe, you can see that I got 5,000 time sand in here. I sort of did. Well, I didn't cheat, but I sort of went to the stuff that you can get in the future. So if we right click on this now, we can get ourselves some nuggets out of this gold. Some gold nuggets. Oh wait, they're not gold. Never mind. Now remember, you are going to need a lot of temporal nuggets to get different things, but the first things you're going to want, you're going to want your temporal ingot. So you can see that we get our temporal nugget. Temporal chips that can be made into temporal nuggets. So 4 temporal chips can be made into a nugget. 9 nuggets can be made into a temporal ingot. The ingot can then be made into your different things that you're going to need. Now you may think this is really tedious and annoying to get, which yes, I would totally agree. But nuggets can be made into a temporal block as well, like, ingots can be made into a temporal block like so. But the things you're going to want is a sedate temporal core and an active temporal core. These are your different time states, so one is the unactive time really, and the other one is the active time. So to make a sedate temporal core, you are going to want 6 nuggets and 1 ingot with 2 stone either side. To get the active one, you're going to want 2 redstone with a temporal ingot in the middle and temporal nuggets on the top and bottoms. Now once you have your temporal cores, you're going to want to make a chronomancer's hourglass. This you need the hourglass, 6 bronze ingots, and a sedate and active temporal core in the top and the bottom. Once you have got this, then this is when your little compass in the middle comes into play. So you can see that we're on air at the moment, because I believe that's what time of day we're on. So this will change as the day goes along. So at the moment we're currently on air, so we want to drop our little chronomancer's hourglass onto that. You can see it's got sand on it, and after a few seconds it should fill up. We can grab it, and now we have a chronomancer's hourglass of wind. So we can also get ourselves some death if we wanted to, so we can just push our hourglass onto a different one, whichever one we want. So there you go, we can see we now have a chronomancer's hourglass of death. But the one that I'm going to go for is I'm going to go for the chronomancer's hourglass of life, which is the little heart at the top. There we go, we got our chronomancer's hourglass of life. So the different hourglasses can be used, but before we get into that, I am going to move on to the different forms of getting our little bits of time sand, because there is an easier way of getting time sand than the one that we've been using with our pickaxes and stuff. So these different forms come in light, lunar, air, water, earth, fire, life, and death. Now, the first 4 are basically passive states, and the second 4 are active states. So the passive ones basically don't really use time. I mean, they take time apart from the world and rip them into themselves, but the second ones actually have to do something. So the first ones, you've got the light fork extractor, which is 2 active temporal cores with 2 temporal ingots and 4 brass ingots with a torch in the middle. The second one is basically the same but with a gas tier. The air one is a feather in the middle. The fourth one is a water bucket in the middle. The earth one is stone in the middle. The fire one is a flint and steel in the middle. The life one is a golden apple in the middle. And the death one is a bone in the middle. Now once you've got those, you are going to want some catalysts. So depending on which one you're using, and we will be using the water one, the water fork extractor, so that recipe, so with the bucket in the middle. We are going to want a water catalyst. So each catalyst goes to their corresponding extractor. The water catalyst is made with 3 buckets of water, 1 temporal ingot, and 3 buckets of lava. The air catalyst is made with 3 feathers and 3 stone with temporal in the middle. The lunar one is made with 3 glass, 1 temporal ingot, and 3 stone. The light one is made with 3 wool, 1 temporal ingot, and 3 glowstone. The earth catalyst is made with 3 stone axes, bit strange, 3 bones, and a temporal ingot. The fire one is made with 3 flint and steels, 3 water, and 1 temporal ingot. The life one is made with 3 wheat, 1 temporal ingot, and 3 light, or torches, sorry, light, what? The death one is made with 3 golden apples, 1 temporal ingot, and 3 stone swords. Now this one, the death one is more for the basically mob spawning, so whenever anything's going to die, then it will actually live, which is why we've got our pig pen over here. I'm going to show you this one. So let's put our little catalyst into here. So if you right click, you can see it's got two skulls, zero in the time sand. But if we put our catalyst in, and then it'll raise the dead, there we go. But we're not getting anything from this. So if we actually go and kill our little piggies here, sorry buddies, I don't want to kill you, but I got to. Wait, they're not dying. That is because this thing is keeping them alive. So you can see we've got 2,000 time sand, and our catalyst used a little bit of durability. This will eventually run out if we kill them enough. But each time that these should die, then they actually don't. They give us some more time sand. There, it should have died. We got 2,000 extra time sand, and they lived. But that is how the death one works. The lunar one and the light one are basically like each other, only slightly different. So the lunar one, if we place this down and we placed the catalyst within it, and then we turn it to nighttime, then it will use the nighttime, but it will charge up slower. So you can see there that we've got 600, 700. It will use the time of night or the time darkness. It will rip that sort of time away from it and put it into here. Whereas with the other one, it's basically the same sort of concept, only different. So if we place the light fork extractor down, and then we put in a light catalyst, it will use the light of the sun and extract it. It'll take time away from the light. So basically, if we had lights around here, it will take the light there. So that's why it's got a torch and two glowstones. So you can see why these are passive. They don't use anything. Whereas with these ones, you actually require piggies or other animals and stuff to actually die before they do it. Same with the life and stuff like that. I mean, believe fire, it extracts the fire off of the mobs that are on fire. So if I was on fire now, then it would be gaining power, and it extracts that and uses that into the time. Life one prevents mobs from spawning and takes the life and uses it in to make time sand. Whereas the earth one will basically, if you've got saplings down, then it will prevent them from growing. And I believe it works with other things like seeds and stuff as well. It prevents them from growing and will then give you time sand from that. And the air one, you basically want to put as high as you can, and it will give you time sand from having it at a height. Now we're going to move on to the water one, which you basically need to place underwater, put a catalyst within it. So you can see we've got a bit of stuff in here. But the thing above it is actually a time well. So we're not collecting anything at the moment, but to get to the time well, you are also going to want some temporal nuggets and stuff for that as well. So the time well, pretty expensive, I will say. You need two active temporal cores, two sedate temporal cores, one temporal ingot, and four brass ingots. So pretty pricey, but once you've got one of these, you are going to want to place it above your little... Hello, Mr. Piggy. We're going to place it on this one, so... But we will need to conjoin these, because these aren't basically gone together yet. So we will need something to combine these together, which we are then going to move on to the time tuner. So for the time tuner, you're going to want five brass ingots and one temporal ingot, and that will give you the time tuner. Once you have the time tuner, you are going to want to right click on your little block that you want to make go to this one. So if you right click on this one, you'll see time walk location saved, blah 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 blah. Then once it gets to, I believe it's a certain amount, then it will transfer over. Let's actually go over to this one, because this one already has a ton in it. So you can see that once it gets to a certain number, it will fill up into here. So we got 50,500 times sand. So there's a lot in that one. So you can basically charge these up. That basically extracts any time sand out on the top slot. And in the middle slot, if you put your tool in, then it will put it into your stuff. So you can hold up to 10,000 time sand, and you can extract it in that one. So that is how you get more time sand into your tools. Time sand is also required for other things, which we will get to in a moment. But the next thing that you are going to want is the pocket watch. So the pocket watch is a bit pricey again, so you're going to want your time sand before you can do that, really. So to make the pocket watch, you're going to want 1 clock, 4 brass ingots, 2 temporal ingots, a active and an sedate temporal core. Now once you've got your pocket watch, you can't really do much with it. Now we're going to press R to open the GUI, but there's nothing we can do. There's just a load of buttons that pop up on the screen. So what's the point in this thing? Well, you're going to have to add these things. These are different modules. Okay, so the first module we have here is the Silk Touch module. With this, this is pricey. You need an enchanting table, 4 string, 1 bookshelf, a sedate temporal core, and 2 temporal ingots. Once you have your Silk Touch module, you're going to want to go to a crafting table. You're going to want to put this in, and you're going to want to put your pocket watch in, and then combine them together. Once you have this, you can press R again, and you can see that we now have Silk Touch. Now, this requires temporal sand, as you would probably expect. No, sorry, not temporal sand, I mean time sand. Ugh, God, I need to get my wording sorted. So, how do you actually get this to work, you probably want to know. Well, the reason for the Chronomancer's Hourglass is to use them as a charge station as well as other things. So, we're going to charge this up by placing this in here. You can see that goes higher than 10,000, so it stores a lot more than you would expect, but that's why they're hourglasses, because they can store a lot more. They're basically your batteries. So now that we have that, it won't use any time sand while disactivated, but once activated, then it will start using some time sand out of here. So let's go out of creative mode, and you can see our little string at the top. If we look here now, we should eventually get across to this, but we're going to hit this with our pickaxe. And instead of breaking, actually, no, we're going to break stone, sorry. Instead of actually making it into cobble, then it will use our Silk Touch on it. And it will basically act like a Silk Touch pickaxe. So that's pretty cool, but you can see that it's used energy out of here. So if we do that again, let's use some more energy, do it again. And it's used some more energy, so it uses about 25 a time by the looks of that, so not too pricey, but it does use your sand pretty quickly. So the next one is your furnace module. This is basically an auto smelter. For this you are going to want 4 little furnaces, 2 lava buckets, 2 temporal ingots, and 1 sedate temporal core. Same again, to place it into your pocket watch. I'm now going to show you the rest of the modules, because I already have a pocket watch with most of these things on them. So you've got the life walk, which is diamond booties, 4 stone, 2 temporal ingots, 1 sedate temporal core, and 2 golden apples. This will give you the life walk module. You have the death walk module. So for this one, it's a diamond sword, 2 diamond boots, 2 temporal ingots, 1 sedate temporal core, 3 stone, and then that will give you the death walk module. And you have the partial gravity module. So the more of these you actually have active, the more time sand it will use, as predictable. But for this, you need 4 feathers, 2 wool, 2 temporal ingots, and 1 sedate temporal core. And then with this, we can now right click. By the looks of it, there may be some more modules added in the future, but for now we only have the basic 5. So if we activate our little pocket watch now and we go back into normal survival and then we chop this down, then we don't have Silk Touch active, and it was still into stone because we used our little burny one. So if we actually pickaxe one of these now, we should get an ingot back, because it auto smelts the block that you are harvesting. So pretty cool. As you would expect with the Featherfall one, it gives you a jump boost. So big jump boost, there you go. So that is actually a pretty big jump boost. And then you will Featherfall down to the ground. So that is a pretty cool one. I like that. That's pretty nice. Pretty nice. With the life walk, as you can see in the top of my screen, top left, we've got 15, 16, 17. So the more you walk, the more life you will have. So let's say that we were going to go and fall off one of these trees up here. Well, we can do, I guess. Let's go up to this one, have a nice big fall, as we should take quite a bit of damage from this. So we got 20 in our little thing there. If we jump off of here, it'll take it down to 12, but we won't take any damage. So that is what the life walk does. The more you gain, then the more life that you are going to have in the long run. With the death one, it's basically the same. The more you walk, then the more things you are going to have on here. I believe this one's more for killing mobs. I'm not entirely sure. I never actually worked it out, and there wasn't anything on the thing page for it. So yeah, this one affects more health. So if you run around, so these charge up to 20, and if we hit a mob, then it should then take down the charge. And unfortunately, it didn't kill it. This might work with swords, I'm not too sure. But yeah, I'm not entirely sure what the death one actually does properly. So apologies for that, but hopefully you guys will work it out. If you can, then put it in the comment section. That would be awesome. And yeah, but we're moving on now. So now you're probably thinking, well, we've got all these hourglasses. What's the point to them? Because, I mean, we can't do anything with them, right? Wrong. You can actually use these like a normal tool, and you will need to grab these. So let's grab a couple of components. So if you stick one of these hourglasses, I'm going to use the life one to start with a clockwork component and a little tension spring. I don't think we actually need the spring, I'm not too sure, but if we put the hourglass with one of those and we then wind it up. So I think we do actually need this, because this is its charge, isn't it? So there we go. And then we also need some time sand in, so let's whack that into the bottom slot. Oh wait, we don't have any time sand because it's all in here already. Oh dear. Okay, so now we have a fully tensionized one of these, and it sort of... Let's right click. So there we go. You can now see we've got regeneration free for 3 seconds. And then it will regenerate, so we actually have it for 4 seconds. And this will use our tension pretty quickly, so there you go, you can see it's using it really quick. But it will keep us alive. And we can also wind it up while using it still. But it will regen us constantly until it is turned off by right-clicking again. With the fire one, then it basically, once you've got it wound up and ready, then you can stand in fire and it'll give you fire resistance. With the water one, it gives you lovely water breathing with some little buffs while there. Activate you, and then you can see we've got water breathing there. And while we're wet, it gives us haste, regeneration free, and night vision. That is really nice. I wish it gave us a bit faster swim, but no, that is really awesome. But that only happens while you're wet or standing in water. Now we're going to move on to the one of death. So this one, we can then put these together, tensionize them up as always. And as you can see, these were actually extracting time sand from other ones. So this one has the time sand in it, so it's extracting it from that one. If we do this one, then it will give us strength free, but it will also give us hunger free and poison too. Now, I'm not dying from poison, but that's why it's called the death hourglass, because it gives us extreme strength but also gives us death in the meantime as well. So bit deadly, but it's cool. Now we got another really cool one, which is the hourglass of wind. So if we right click here, we can go flying. Whee! So we're just literally flying forward. It will take us wherever we go if we want to. So we can go high, we can go low. Does this still work underwater? No. So it doesn't work underwater, unfortunately. But yeah, that's what the hourglass of wind does. It stops us in water. That's a shame, but oh well. We had a nice flying adventure, and and then we can just right click again to stop it. So that one is really cool. I like that one. That is sweet. I'm not entirely sure what the hourglass of the moon actually does, unfortunately, so apologies for that, but I can't really do anything with this one at the moment, and there's not much that it actually says about on the wiki, so unfortunately, I don't know what this one does, so a bit annoying. With the hourglass of Earth, you can walk on water! Hey! No, but this one actually allows you to walk on the area that you started. So let's say we started on this block here, we activate it. We will stay up on that level until we deactivate it. Blub, 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 blub. Hello, Mr. Squid. So that one's pretty cool. So if we stood here and we activated it, we can stay standing on here until we deactivate it. It's a pretty cool one, that one. And then we have our last hourglass, I am afraid. It's a shame, but oh well. But our last hourglass is the hourglass of a light or whatever. And if we turn it to nighttime here and we activate this, then it will generate a little hourglass light block, which is really cool. It will generate a small particle of light, so if we go over here, then you can see it's still activating them to light up the area a little while we're dark. So I think that's a pretty cool one. That's nice until you deactivate it, and then it won't do anything, but it'll keep the blocks there, and then we can just literally right click them in Adventure, can we? Yeah, so one little right click, or left click, sorry, not right click. And then they will be gone. So that's pretty cool. It lights up the area a little. Same as this thing. It lights up the area a little bit. Not too much. I think it's like redstone level. So, but that's pretty cool. And nice. So awesome. But now we're going to move on to our final item, which is the temporal multi-tool. Now remember guys, this mod is still in early development really, so more things will be added in the future, and I think that will be pretty cool because I really like this mod. I want to put this in my series already. So the temporal multi-tool is, it says hold shift for details, it's blank. But the temporal multi-tool, you need 2 active temporal cores, 2 sedate temporal cores, 1 temporal ingot, and you will get yourselves the temporal multi-tool. What you do with the temporal multi-tool is if you go over to a crafting bench and you want to stick in your tools. Now no, you can't put 2 in at once, you can only put 1 in once. And then you want to take out the temporal multi-tool. Hold shift, now you'll see item Invar Axe. And now if we put our time tuner in, then we got the time tuner as item 2. If we put in our pickaxe, then we got our pickaxe as item 3. So it holds it all in this sweet little multi-tool. So if we press V now, you can see our tools here, and you can click on them. So now we've got our axe, you can press V again, we can get our multi-tool so we can craft more. And then so on and so forth with our different things. So I think this one's a really cool one. I like this. This is nice. But it has to be the multi-tool when you're putting it into the crafting table. Do note though that this is still a bit of a implemented thing. So it's a little bit of a work in progress. And do note that some mods may be a little incompatible with it. And it may use up the whole of the multi-tool or whatever. So do keep that in mind. But yeah, so I think that's pretty much it for the mod spotlight. I think I've shown you everything I can. Remember the different things such as the hourglasses. These have different abilities as the different like speeds and qualities are. So I presume like the more quality you have on one, then it'll give it more of a like regen. But the more speed you have on one, like the regen, then the more faster it will go up. So, yeah, but that's pretty much the mod. I think it's a really cool mod. It's pretty new out there, and to be honest, it has a lot of stuff in, some really nice graphics and stuff played with it. So, I think it's pretty cool. So, we're currently on the sun stage, so I presume that's like midday, I don't know. But yeah, so but if you delete one block off of here, then it'll go a little bit strange, and yeah, then delete the middle one and it will delete the whole thing. So this has been the Clockwork Phase mod. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful in any way. So if it was, remember to hit that like button and subscribe if you're new to my channel, because that would be totally awesome. And you guys are awesome, so hi. But anyway, yeah, so hope you guys enjoyed this video. This has been the Clockwork Phase mod for Minecraft 1.7.10. And I will put links in the description so you guys can go check it out and mess around with the hourglasses and stuff yourselves. And yeah, so hope you guys enjoyed. I have been Pokepeel, and I will see you guys next time. Bye! Boom.